Welcome to the first event at the biathlon here at the Winter Universiade 2019 in Krasnoyarsk at this wonderful biathlon academy here. And already we've seen the preparations of their team technicians and of course the officials too, who have this burden thrust upon them. It's very quickly done, the checking of the rifles, the serial numbers and the magazines and the trigger pressure and so on. And this is an opportunity to just have a look at some of the 31 competitors who'll be stepping out onto this arena. It's a delight to see this particular venue, the Biathlon Academy in Krasnoyarsk, which has undergone major reconstruction and refit and improvement specifically to host this event. Not many people would have believed that when Krasnoyarsk was awarded this event that the temperature would be just below freezing point and that there'd been no snow in recent weeks. This is the start list for the first event, the women's 15 kilometer individual. There are 31 competitors from 13 countries. Each of these nations is entitled to enter six, a maximum of six competitors, but just the host nation Russia has taken advantage of that, and there's no doubt with their extraordinary strength and depth that they will be a force to be reckoned with in this event. The Czech Republic and Canada each have four. We see there Zhukova from the Czech Republic on that list, three from Poland and three from Norway. They are the dominant nations here numerically anyway. The privilege of being first away in the women's individual at the 2019 Winter Universiade Biathlon event goes to Piper Vinot of Canada. She's a 19-year-old. She was born in Ottawa, Canada. She's a member of a 12-strong team, and she will be followed 30 seconds later by the first of the Russians, Voronina of Russia, 24 years of age, from the Ural, the famous Ural district. And she will be immediately seeing the target on the back of the young Canadian in front of her. A member of the junior Russian team, a bronze medalist at the junior world championship relay last year. Timur Pulatova will be one of the athletes we would expect to feature towards the end. Wearing number five, watch for her progress throughout this race. First of those who can be regarded as local, studying at the University of Krasnoyarsk here in the host city, Elena Chukova, 25-year-old, and with the knowledge that so many of her family and friends and fellow students are here watching, she'll be spurred on to really good things today. Watch that, number 13, Chukova of Russia. Fischer from Switzerland coming up to the 1.8 kilometer split. Second place at the moment. The first time we have a look at this 50 meter range, Tamara Voronina of Russia, 24 years of age. Well, she's already lost that advantage she had for the first miss. 1 minute penalty. Makes a quick shoot with the remainder. Timira Bulatova of Russia is ahead of Voronina, also of Russia. And in third place, or third and fourth, the two Norwegians. That was going through 3.8. Those two leaders have gone through 4.4 now. Oh, Chukova, very good. Russia, Russia, the Czech Republic, Russia and Poland. That was at the 4.4 kilometer split. We're back on the range now. Gerbulova. Also from the University of Krasnoyarsk, 24-year-old, quickly gets the rifle on her back, sorts out the straps on the poles, and away she goes. So we can sense already that that the Russians, through Timur Belotova and Turkova, are really challenging. Now we see for the first time this initial climb and our leader. Just notice the difference in style there, with Kittelsen looking to be just laboring somewhat. And then we see the drive from Turkova. It's a totally different style, determination. She will have targeted the skier in front of her and will be pushing to gain that advantage. That's powerful driving from her. A long way to go in this, and it only needs one miss at the next visit to the range, and suddenly things will change. This is a chance to get the breathing under control. You can imagine what the heart rate is like and how heavy the breathing is. Just see the chest and stomach area as the breathing is controlled. Well, she's missed one there, so that takes her back a minute. That's hope for the others. Clean through. Now, just laboring slightly there. We can see Mirajovsky of Canada and slipping past is Voronina. Now, she started in second place. She quickly made up the 30-second disadvantage she had. She shot well. Now coming into view, Kittelsen of Norway. Ahn of Korea, just in the background there. Timur Belatova. Driving up the hill, it's quite a reasonable climb. Then the relaxation and the ability just to rest and recover on the downhill. Into the range again. Gubulova, number 22, concentration. Slowly takes the rifle off, checks, loads the magazine, gets the breathing under control, chest heaving, and now slowed in time for the first, which is a good shot. And the second. And the third. Oh, a fourth, and disappointment for her from the university, the local university. This is her home training area. This is where she spends a lot of her time. She shot very well initially. Oh, I shouldn't have spoken. A minute added there too. Oh, she'll be so very disappointed with that. This is Alexandra Belobova. Also coming in is our favourite, perhaps. Let's see what she can do here. Most of the athletes favour the prone chute. change to the wind out there. It's pretty much still. Oh, excellent shoot. Excellent. Dima Bulatova rips through those five rounds. Now, another who must feature surely from Surgut State University is 23-year-old Kaplina. Haven't seen much of her. Wearing number 26, starting from way down the back of the field. She'll be delighted to have that big zero next to her name. Perfect on the range, and it may well prove to be the difference. What can she manage here? Oh, a miss. Expect that from Cherkova with her form today, but a minute penalty for her still keeps her in contention, of course, because she's skiing so well, and apart from that one blemish, she shot perfectly. Just that odd one or two. Well, Gurbolova, just two, and her friends are disappointed with that. And they do know that she is still in there. One more visit to the range. Voronina has another target in front of her. Crucial. This is her final visit to the range. Standing shoot. Two misses so far. Both of those have occurred in the prone position. Wonderful, absolutely wonderful. There's Voronina, Tamara Voronina, number two. What she needs to do now is to race home and hope that others in contention continue to struggle. Taking a time. Oh, gosh. That didn't help. So 2 minutes added. And here we see, after the third visit to the range, Russia, the first four were all from the home nation. Up to the 10.8 kilometer. Cherkova, 34.18, and we will keep an eye on the gap closing. Gurbolova at 10.8. His fastest through that split. Thank you. time. She didn't need that first shot to go astray. Timur Belatova, what she got in her? Three misses at the range has hurt, without doubt. Big advantage of being in behind someone is that you have that target and you can just find some energy that you didn't think you had to get up and try and push past. In this case, it's Moshkova just having a few meters advantage. Number 22, Natalia Gubolova, based here in Krasnoyarsk, knows this course exceptionally well, knows everything about it, spends a lot of time at the Biathlon Academy here, and she comes in to relax, to get her breathing under control, to put everything else out of her mind, flips the magazine in, steadies her breathing. Can she get through clean? She looked to be shooting so quickly and accurately, so it is still on here. Gubolova concedes a minute. And she's still going to take over from Jurkova. So Gubolova. And here, our early leader, Veronina. Soon we'll be seeing the first finishes. The crowd will roar as she comes to the finish. She started 30 seconds down, and now the first of the competitors comes home, and it is Tamara Voronina of Russia. What an outstanding performance from her. She went out on a mission here. She skied her heart out. She shot very well. It all depends on how these athletes get through this last standing shoot. Taking a long time over that last, and that's clear. Moshkova. This 21-year-old is doing everything she can to get up there among the medals. Costly at the range for her. Natalia Gubolova from the University of Krasnoyarsk here in the host city. She's wearing the number 22. She's just in front of Lila Lipoti of Canada. She won't even be aware of that. She's just striving to maintain her advantage. Here she comes now. Oh, this is Moshkova. And Moshkova is a minute plus down on Gubolova through the 13.5. Open, gasping, striving, working those skis over time. This is a great shot as they come out of the trees, this wonderful forest area. This will be fantastic if Gubolova can win in front of the home audience. This impressive facility here, which has had in recent times a whole new update of the stand and the lighting and the course itself. And across the line comes Jurkova of Russia, collapsing to the ground. She's given her all, as you would expect. Thank you. about a minute down on the leader. She skis as if she knows she's got this rut won. She's looking very smooth, takes advantage of the downhill, relaxes. Hard into her work again. She'll be able to hear the crowd. And she will know, will she break into a grin here? Kubulova of Russia comes to the finish line. Takes the lead. .46 for her. And it was her shooting which and her skiing, because others had slightly better performances on the range. But she has skied sensationally today. Moshkova has been there or thereabouts. She was second going through the 13.8. And she is going to be second across the line. ...10 meters to go. And can she get into second? She just nudges out Cherkova. And at the moment, and it may well stay that way, it's 1, 2, and 3. For athletes from Russia. Natalia Gubulova has been the standout performer. So this race, as expected, turned into a battle between the top Russian competitors. But it was won by Gubulova and Moshkova in second, Cherkova in third place. So a definite statement from the host nation here in Krasnoyarsk. All three medalists represent Russia in the first biathlon event, the women's individual.